Genius Zone number 6, revealing what happens on settlement day and post-settlement bliss. So wow, we're here. We're here at the finish line, the day of settlement when all of the hard work comes to fruition and you become the official owner of your dream home. The settlement's been scheduled for at least a couple weeks or so in most cases. You've already looked over the preliminary alta, which basically breaks down every penny of the transaction. You've done your final walkthrough of the house. Your realtor has snapped photos of the gas meter and the water meter to confirm those final readings, and you have an Uber on its way to take you to the settlement in style. So, what actually happens the day of settlement? Who attends settlement, and what should you expect? A common settlement for the home bought in Philadelphia usually has your dream team present. And you remember who the dream team is: your lender, your realtor, and of course you. But at settlement, the seller, their realtor, possibly some friends and family if you need the support, and a person you have never met is going to be there, a person from the title company. What does the title company do at settlement, and why are they so important? To answer those questions, I have asked my team member, Sean Dundon, an experienced agent and a real estate investor, I might add, to get those answers for you by interviewing a real title company. Hey, Sean.
Hi.
I'm so glad you're here. So let's cut to your video.
Hi, my name is Mike Riley. I'm with Statewide Abstract. We're a title insurance company in Philadelphia. I'm going to explain a little bit what the purpose of title insurance is and how we protect the buyers. So for most people, when they buy a home, that's one of their largest investments. And when they purchase the home, they want to make sure that they're actually getting the entire home. Now, what do I mean by that? When you buy a home, you want to make sure that it's free and clear of anything from the old owner. That could be a mortgage, past due real estate taxes, gas, water and sewer, anything that's past due can be leaned against the house. When you're purchasing that home, you don't want to inherit the previous owner's debts. You want to make sure it's free and clear. Just like when you buy a car, you want to make sure that there's no lien against it. We issue an insurance policy, and if anything ever comes up in the future, you can file a claim, and it's on us, not you as the buyer. You're totally free and clear. So the difference between title insurance and mortgage insurance is that mortgage insurance only covers the lender. Covers the lender in the event of a foreclosure. It makes sure that they get their money back, basically. Title insurance insures you as the buyer of a home, so you don't have to worry about anything in the future. You're totally safe, you're secure, and you own your home. What is the difference between the ALTA form and the buyer's closing disclosure? Both of them are similar, where they break down all the costs, all the fees, and all the money that's going in or out of the transaction. The difference is that the buyer's closing disclosure also breaks down all the terms of the mortgage. It's very similar to the promissory note. What does a person need to bring to settlement? Usually, at the point of the process where you're going to the settlement, the buyer's already been approved for their mortgage. Everything is pretty much done. The only thing the buyer really needs is a valid photo ID and certified funds to close. So one story that I have, we had a transaction where somebody was selling and somebody was buying a house. Everything went smooth at the closing. The buyer purchased the home, and he found out a month later that the seller, unbeknownst to anybody else, had gone out and taken a mortgage on the house the day before settlement, the day before he sold the house. What happens is that mortgage sticks to the house no matter what. So the buyer called us very upset that there was this mortgage stuck on their brand new house. But luckily, because they had title insurance, all the buyer needed to do was submit a claim. We're responsible for it. The title company insurance paid off that mortgage, and the buyer was free and clear with his house again.
So now I have a few questions for you, Sean. So you have been to hundreds of settlements with clients, and you yourself have made quite a few home purchases. So I consider you an expert. You know, you're pretty smooth with settlements. But let's discuss what those what the heck moments could possibly be on the day of settlement. I call them snags, that could maybe delay settlements. So first question, you ready? Okay. What is the importance of the final buyer walkthrough?
Well, the final buyer walkthrough is to make sure that the house is still standing it didn't catch on fire, the roof didn't cave in, and you want to make sure it's still what you remember it was from, you know, the initial walkthrough. Also, you want to make sure that any repairs that the seller may have agreed to do are complete prior to going to the settlement table.
Okay. So what do you do if the house is not, like, broom swept? Because in the contract it says you should, you know, sweep up, but not broom swept, and maybe the owners have left some stuff behind?
So it's really up to you as the buyer what you want to do at the end of the day, but you can either accept it the way it is and just deal with it if it's a small amount of stuff. Otherwise, you can potentially get a small credit to help pay for that clean-out service. Or you can sometimes have to, or you may want to postpone settlement if there's enough stuff there to give the seller enough time to get it all out so that when you take over the property, it is vacant or empty.
Mm-hmm. So that could possibly delay settlement. So what other possible causes for delays in settlement?
You just never know. It could be scheduling conflicts. There's a lot of moving parts, title and lender, buyer, seller, agent. So it really just a matter of coordinating everyone's schedule. But again, anything can happen. Sometimes the mortgage isn't ready and that might push back settlement a couple of days. You just don't know. Until the day of settlement, sometimes, you know, you don't know if it's going to happen. But ideally, everything goes as planned. But as we know, that's not always
the case. We don't live in an ideal world, absolutely. So do you, on that note, do you recommend a buyer hiring movers for the day of settlement?
No, because...
That was a definitive answer,
I mean, you just never know. And then at the end of the day, your movers are showing up, all your stuff is in a truck, and you don't even have a house to go to. And then you might be like, you have no place to stay. So, I mean, like, until you settle, sign, and get those keys, anything can happen. So what if you, you know, so it's better just to be sure that it's your home before you start moving into your home.
Yeah, especially if you're a renter and you're like, your rent, your lease ends that day and now you're homeless, you don't want to be in that situation. So thank you, that was a great answer. So how does a buyer handle getting utilities put in their names on the day of settlement?
So, you know, pretty much you call the day of or right after settlement. As soon as you're done, you call your local gas, electric company, cable, water's covered by the title company, they take care of that. Goes with the house, you don't have to worry about that. But otherwise, you want to make sure you call your gas, your electric, and your internet, your cable.
Yeah, good advice. So should a buyer use the same keys as, you know, so you get all these keys at settlement, they're like, hey, the home is yours, and then you take the key and, like, what do you do?
No.
Okay. Another definitive answer, no.
No.
And don't keep those keys.
Because you just never know. Like, you just don't know who has a key to that house. So it's just better to be safe than sorry. It's one of the smallest, you know, expenses you can have buying a new home. Just peace of mind, just get new keys.
I would agree with that too. So what happens if something goes wrong in the house after settlement?
You're a homeowner. Welcome to home ownership. So from that point on, it's pretty much your home, your problem. Hopefully it's not a large problem, but at the end of the day, it's your home. You get to take care of it how you want to take care of it. Unless it's something that was agreed upon prior to settlement, and then clearly it wasn't, maybe, but otherwise, it's your home, it's your new responsibility, and you make it what it is.
Yep, very good. Very good advice, though. So let's talk about post-settlement, okay? I'm calling it the post-settlement bliss because basically I'm talking about watching the home's equity grow over time. And, you know, as a homeowner and an investor, you have some pretty good insights on this. So I'm going to ask you a couple more questions. How quickly will a home typically appreciate? Like, I'm thinking like 3, 7, 3, 5, 7, that type of year span.
So every neighborhood, everything is different. We really don't have a crystal ball to really know. But at the end of the day, real estate generally appreciates with or above inflation. So at the end of the day, you're going to be at least at a minimum 3 to 5% a year. Mm-hmm. At a very healthy conservative number. However, if there's a lot of development in the area, that can be anywhere from, you can go 20-30% a year.
Yeah,
you just don't
we've
know.
Seen that, which is pretty amazing.
So, but yeah, at the end of the day, it generally goes up and goes up with inflation, so you should see some sort of appreciation.
Mm-hmm. As long as the economy is working on our behalf. So, another question I have for you. What are a few of the maintenance tips you can give us that will help maintain the home's, like, health for, you know, value purposes?
Outside elements. You want to make sure nothing's getting, no water penetration. So you want to, every few years, keep an eye on your roof, maybe get it recoated every few years. Something that no one ever does, but they should do, is like go around the perimeter of your home, recaulk every 2 to 4 years, make sure there's no just any water penetration getting into your home. That's the best way to preserve your home is from the outside elements. Service your heater every winter, every other winter. Just make sure that thing keeps working. You don't want it to not work during the winter when you need it the most. Best to get it fixed prior to it getting cold or serviced. Those are like the two main things. But just like be conscious of your home. If you don't take care of little things right away, they turn into big things.
Absolutely.
And soon it's a huge laundry list to do. And, you know, so.
So a homeowner owns the home for a couple of years. You know, what upgrades should a person consider doing in their house to increase the value?
If you're going to do any upgrades, it's always the same. I'm sure you've heard it. Kitchens and bathrooms. That's where you're going to get the most value, most, you know, benefit from those upgrades. So kitchens and bathrooms, hardwood flooring is another one.
Yeah.
Those are your main things. Little things you can do is like, that's really helpful. Like light fixtures, like little accents. You can do things that really just help your home look better, show better for the next person.
Yeah, I think that's awesome. So what are the benefits of being a landlord? Because you're a landlord, I'm a landlord, we're landlords. Good to meet you. But what are the benefits of being a landlord if in a few years, you know, you want to move, but you don't really want to sell the property?
So one benefit is you have an asset and that asset continues to grow once you move on. So while you're not living there, your asset's growing. You're also collecting hopefully some income over the mortgage. So therefore you're also making some sort of small profit over your mortgage. Also tax deduction wise, it's a good tax deduction, depreciation. And at the end of the day, you are allowed to sell that asset. As long as you've lived in it for two of the previous 5 years, you can sell that and not pay capital gains. Although you want to talk to your accountant more about that. So I usually tell people if you're going to move from a property and you don't need to sell it, you probably want to rent it for 2 to 3 years prior to selling it if you really want to maximize your asset and get the most out of it.
That's excellent advice, excellent advice. So my last question for you is, do you recommend an average homeowner becoming an investor like you?
Yes, it's not for everybody. It is another job. You're not going to get rich overnight, but you will slowly make money in your sleep. Because as time goes on, these assets grow. And so I think it's, I highly recommend it, encourage it to people to explore it. But it's really a matter of how much time you have, how much money you have to invest. It's just another way of investing. So stocks, mutual funds, property. So it's silver, gold. It's all the same. It depends on how much risk aversion you have and how involved you want to be, because real estate compared to a lot of other investments is just a bit more hands-on. So.
And also, it could be a little less risky, though, as far as like the financial investment. So, you know.
Yeah.
Awesome. Really great answers.
I think it's a great idea.
I kind of do, too. We agree. So thanks, Sean, for sharing this priceless information with us for the final course. So we're kind of ending things for everyone. Thank you for watching and for joining us on the journey to Buyer Genius. But as part of this final course, I've included a sample settlement sheet and a sample title report, so you can check that out. You have received a ton of information and materials from us, so remember to check those out. If you have any questions about the process of buying or investing, Sean and I are here to help you. You are officially Buyer Geniuses. Boom. I'm Stephanie Summers from the Summers team at Keller Williams, Philadelphia.